No one has ever asked that before.
No.
That's okay. I'm a percussionist. We'll get to that later. That's the only other person that usually is like, oh God, no. But this is fine. So I brought him up here to do this, which is something I don't ever get to do with my band, which is kind of scary. So I had some vocal trouble a few years back when it was really fashionable to have vocal trouble. Like Adele had vocal trouble, and John Mayer had vocal trouble, and you know, Steven Tyler had vocal trouble. It's like, oh. I had to do 10 days where I didn't speak at all. I learned something really cool. As long as you go to the same coffee house you always go to, you can get your drink the way you want it without ever having said a word, and no one will notice. The usual? Whipped cream on that? That'll be 10 days. No one realized I never said anything. But I was miserable, and so I started humming when I first kind of got more comfortable talking again, and hummed sort of what went along with this. And started reading up about Jackson Pollock. So this is why I'm doing this song. So Jackson Pollock, you know, it looks like splatter paper. There are people who say that there are fractals in it, all kinds of things. And I was thinking that when birds take a crap on the hood of your car, it is the reincarnated spirit of Jackson Pollock desperately trying to communicate with you, and you take your car to the car wash. Jackson Pollock's painting for a long time held the record as the most expensive, meanwhile, underground art sale. It was like $1.7 million. And he actually died in a car accident. So I thought that was kind of interesting. Perfect length story. So this is a song called Pollock, which I don't do very often, so this will be it.
Thank you.
express my heart. Without hands or wings or song, be a prison for my soul. Would it be better to go on alone, and not even at all? Telephone home.